welcome to another groundbreaking episode of The Reality of Wrestling, as tonight we are going to see NXT's Lexis King taking on the cornerstone of this company, Ryan Davidson. And we are just 1 week away for the big Reality of Wrestling Championship match that will see Natty Ice with Booker T in his corner taking on the challenger, Gaspar Hernandez.
The following contest is a tag team match scheduled for one fall, and it is for the Reality of Wrestling Tag Team Championships. Introducing first, from Ottumwa, Iowa, the team of J.P. Harlow, Joey Hyder, and they are the Highwaymen!
The Highwaymen, J.P. and Joey, trying again for a tag team championship.
Don't mind me, I'm just doing what I'm supposed to do.
And their opponents, from Houston, Texas, they are the current Reality Wrestling Tag Team Champions, the team of Blood Brother Warren J.
The four-time Reality Wrestling Tag Team Champions making their way down to the ring for another championship defense against opponents that they are very familiar with, Brittany.
Yes, the Highwaymen. But look at this, coming out here with more aggression, I would have to say, in Fly Death as of late with this new tag team reign here.
Possibly one of the most impressive reigns thus far, as Fly Depp just continues to get better and better, most recently having defended those championships at one of our breakout shows. Oh, it gets better together, and now the Highwaymen already getting in the head of Fly Depp.
Well, I mean, nothing has changed here for Joey and JP. They've always been that way. And look at this, starting off with Joey Hyder here and Fly Brother. Warren J.
As the jaw-jacking has begun, these two teams do not like each other. And there we go, the bell has rung. This match is now underway for the Tag Team Championships. We saw last week Danny Limelight open the show and defend the championship, the Empire State Championship. Could Fly Def do the same here today, Brad?
They absolutely could pull this off and retain the titles against the Highwaymen, which, by the way, I like these guys. I like the
Highwaymen. Cover here. Quick kick out.
I like them. I mean, they remind me of a throwback. Just two badasses trying to beat somebody up. Remind me of the APA, you know?
Good throwback.
That is indeed what they remind me of. But, oh, look at that. J.P. Harlow now.
They remind you of the APA? Yeah. We can't have the same thought. That's impossible. I reject a reality where you and I think the same.
Yeah, me too. Never mind.
And now these two, all four guys.
Referee's got to take control of this.
Now JP goes after Zaxzilla, and Hyder goes after Warren.
We're not even 2 minutes into this competition here, and we already have lost complete control as Hyder is sent out of the ring, and now JP is left all by himself.
Now, Brittany, with the familiarity that these two teams have against each other, how fast do you think you have to evolve your game to ensure your playbook isn't countered?
Well, as you said, you always learn something new when you're in the ring against somebody.
Oh, quick cover here. One, two, kick out.
But like I was saying before, Fly Death has had this new aggression to them. And from what I've seen of the Highwaymen, they're pretty much up to the same old trick. So Fly Death has definitely have them scouted.
Now, J.P. Harlow got a headlock here in the center of the ring. Zaxzilla, the powerhouse of Fly Def. We have seen him pull off some amazing things. Did some great stuff at the Road Games just a few weeks ago.
Oh! Definitely won't want that elbow in the face.
And now, you saw that right there. Hyder knew exactly where he was, and he got the opening for Harlow. And now we see a tag. as the Highwaymen.
They know what this means. They know what this moment means. Look at that.
Oh, my God.
And here comes flawed brother Warren Jay.
Zaxzilla ate that sidewalk slam on the outside, but now into the cover here with a kick out from Zaxzilla. Hyder in the full mount, just dropping those right hands right into Zaxzilla. He's the one that created the opening by bringing down the ropes, sending Zaxzilla crashing to the outside. Oh, but he gets met with a chop, Brittany, and here he goes.
Back and forth, and we do have to say, we used to talk about Zilla here, Zaxzilla being the powerhouse, but look at Joey Hyder here. He's put on some size. He's put on some mass. He's definitely,
Joey Hyder looks excellent. I agree with you. I mean, he looks trim. He looks ready to go. Looks like a powerhouse. And then here comes JP Harlow. These guys like to put it on you. Man, look at that.
And you saw JP Harlow there in the corner. He made his way to the top turnbuckle to lessen the blow for Hyder, creating an opening now into the cover. But a kick out from Zaxzilla to continue this matchup.
And there's that collegiate wrestling background of JP Harlow coming into full effect.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget, later on tonight, our main event is going to be Ryan Davidson meeting NXT's own Lexis King. And what a matchup that's going to be tonight, as JP Harlow, and now that's tossed.
Zaxzilla in need to tag his partner in.
Yes, but
Harlow with a tag.
Hyder already in and taking out Fly Brother Warren Jay.
Oh, and look at this. Oh, Black Thunder Bomb.
Is that enough?
Zach can't even go for the cover. He's taking too much damage. He's trying to get fired up, Brittany.
Yeah, the damage he took outside the ring onto the floor is enough, let alone everything. He's been in there the longest in this entire match.
But you don't become four-time tag team champions by accident, as Fly Brother Warren Jay makes his way to the ring. He is the legal man, and he is taking out the Highwayman.
Right now, Warren Jay's got him on his shoulders, got Joey Hyder. Blind tag from JP Harlow. Warren was not aware of it, and now here comes JP, but guess what? It didn't matter.
Warren is...
Warren Jay just clears house.
And now, Fly Brother Warren Jay, looking to fly to the outside.
Life and limb.
He took out Hyder, and now it looks like his eye is on Harlow.
Oh, no, not again.
One for one. Oh,
my gosh, and a senton through the ropes. Warren Jay beating the hell out of JP Harlow, doing what he's supposed to do.
He's got to get him back in the ring, and watch out, ref. Ref almost went with him.
That wouldn't upset me.
Rad.
Warren Jay in prime position to take out Harlow from the top.
Cover. He's
to retain the gold. One, two. That's going to do it now. JP Harlow still with the wherewithal to get his shoulder up and break up the pinfall. And this is where Fly Def and the Highwaymen have to start digging deeper into their playbook.
But look at this. Look at Warren Jay already had something in mind, something planned.
With that right hand, JP Harlow crumbles right into the corner, and Warren Jay has him set up for something here.
Don't want to take too much time, as every second counts.
Runs right through. Oh, basement drop kick connected right to the face of Harlow. And now Fly Def could be just moments away from retaining the gold. Hold on a second. Hyder out of nowhere. Created a little bit of time. JP Harlow connects with a knee to the top. And here we see a tag. The Highwaymen.
Uh-oh. JP up there. What is going on?
From the top, Superflex connects. And now Hyder. Standing shooting star.
One,
and now one, two, but a kick out. Somehow Warren still kicked out after the superplex. and standing shooting star combination.
I thought that was it. It looks like JP is shocked, but Joey's trying to rally him back up and say, no, come on, let's go. Let's finish this.
Setting up here for a wheelbarrow something. But oh, Zexel out of nowhere. Roll through Warren to retain the gold. No,
not enough. Not enough.
These two teams have been to war before, and they are just adding another chapter into their book here for the Reality of Wrestling Tag Team Championships.
Look at this. Up on their feet, all four men. Oh, no!
And now it's just an all-out brawl.
Just a brawl. I think this benefits JP and Joey, though. This is what the kind of fight they like. Just a regular old fight.
You said that throwing it back old school.
Yes, but oh, it looks like they're going to be fighting with themselves as their faces collide in the center of the ring. And look at this.
I can't believe this is barely our opening contest. They're setting the bar so high for everybody else for the remainder of the night. Just fly down from the top.
In stereo.
Oh, oh. Double splash.
Cover.
One, two,
and no. Oh. Not enough. Joey Hyder able to kick out.
Now what do they have in mind here? Is Zaczyla trying to reset the table or maybe just keep Harlow away from Hyder? It's now Zach from the top.
Oh my gosh.
Oh
my God, right in front of us here.
Oh my goodness.
Roll through here in the center. Warren to win. No. Oh, right hand from Harlow.
The tag.
The Highwaymen.
Wait a minute. They're looking for it.
Now.
Highway robbery.
The cover. One, two,
three.
Oh my
God.
Absolutely incredible display here from the Highwaymen as they finally manage to defeat Fly Death for championship gold for the very first time, Brittany.
And I'm just shocked again, like Brad said, robbery, but you gotta give it to them. They went all in, all out with Fly Death, and they have come out victorious by hook or by crook.
That was just our opening contest here as we see JP Harlow and Joey Hyder celebrating their victory here as the new Reality of Wrestling Tag Team Champions. But don't go anywhere. We got Mo Rowe for you here today.
Nowhere to run.
Bro Nation, this is CT the Mic Slayer, and I'm here joined by Lexis King, the king of NXT. You're outside of your NXT bubble, and you're making your debut here at Reality of Wrestling. How do you plan to start your reign?
Well, sweet Carolina, my reign is going to be quite short because the reality is I'd rather not be here tonight. The reality is that the king would love to be sleeping in his own bed tonight. And the reality is I'm only here to do a big, solid favor for the former king himself, Booker T. And the reality is that the man standing across from me in that ring tonight is gonna get his ass kicked. And everybody in the building is gonna be chanting the same thing. Long live Lexis King.
Okay, for everybody, we've had the Row Games. And if you missed out, you missed out on something that was very, very exciting, very, very big, and make sure you get ready for the next one. But right now, we're gonna bring out the first ever winner of the inaugural 2024 Rogue Games, Terron Beckham.
Terron Beckham.
Look at this. Congratulations, Terron.
If you weren't there, ladies and gentlemen, make sure that you catch the videos on social media, because this man completely tore up the competition. He is just a specimen, and we got to see it in action.
All of it on YouTube as well, Reality Wrestling's YouTube.
Okay, well, tell you what, we're going to bring out the man who's going to present the check, and that is Stephen Mark Gray. Come on, make some love, show some love.
Mr. Stephen here to present the check to Terron Beckham.
And this is so exciting. I mean, look at, we already know that Terron Beckham is an athlete, but showcasing this here in Rogue Games is phenomenal to showcase our up-and-coming athletes here for Reality of Wrestling and beyond.
What is up, wrestling fans? Awesome. I am Stephen with JMK5. We were so proud to sponsor the Rogue Games this year, and I am here tonight to give a $5,000 check on behalf of JMK5 to Terron Beckham. $5,000, my man. This man's a winner right here.
$5,000, Kirby. Why didn't we get involved in this?
I don't think I can hold a candle to Terron Beckham, honestly.
I believe in you.
How do you feel? And tell the Rogue Nation just what's going on right now.
I feel great. You know, first off, you know, I'm thankful for this opportunity. I'm thankful for Rogue Nation for being behind me. And now I get to go all around the world to be named as the first Rogue Games Ultimate Athlete.
There can only be one first, Kirby.
And there can only be one Dex.
What is...
This is the Dex Master!
All right, I've always wanted to do this. Let's see how I do.
All right.
Dex the Line Dixon!
That was really good, Kirby. That was great.
Thank you.
You know, and I know, that the only reason you won the Rogue Games is because I wasn't there. I'm the ultimate athlete!
Well, these two just continue to go after one another, and the brawl is breaking out, just like every single time before.
Get the check!
Dex Dixon saying that he's the ultimate athlete, and now a brawl has completely broken out, and security is just trying to keep them apart.
The Rogue Nation saying let them fight, but we don't have them scheduled to fight here. This is not sanctioned.
We don't have a referee out here, and our security. This is just breaking out completely as Terron gets the upper hand.
Andrew Jackson said he's going to take care of the check, and he's going to handle everything at a later time as he was passing me.
I'm glad somebody's keeping track of that there for them. As now Dex, he seems just incensed here.
Calm down, Dex. He's throwing. Hold on to your stuff, Kirby.
Terron, I tell you what, if you're a real man, you take that $5,000, I take my $5,000, and we meet at Summer of Champions for a $10,000 prize fight.
Whoa.
Whoa, Dex the Line Dixon laying down the challenge.
Whoa.
He put up $5,000 of his own dollars, and he said that at Summer of Champions, we're going to see a $10,000 prize fight.
You thought Mike Tyson and Jake Paul were going to be a thing. We got Terron Beckham and Dex the Line Dixon and a $10,000 prize fight at Summer of Champions.
I can't wait. Summer of Champions can't come soon enough.
We all know that an accident takes only seconds, but the injuries can last a lifetime. If you've been hurt in a car wreck, a truck wreck, or a motorcycle accident, give me a call. You'll be glad you did. And why would you call anyone else?
I do. It's
come in.
Andrew.
Thank you. Thank you for coming in. All right, have a seat, please.
What's this about?
Okay.
We looked at the footage. And of the last TV championship match between you and Eric Lockhart, and we have hardcore evidence of his foot, his leg, clearly under the rope. Now, it's going to...
Excuse me. Can someone... Oh. I recognize you. I'm you. I'm you. Idiot. Idiot.
Okay.
I'm sorry, Clay.
You should be apologizing to me. Don't say sorry to him. You cost me the Lockhart Television Championship.
I called what I saw.
Okay. Thank you for your time. Give us a few minutes, please.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. As I was saying, you see the evidence. It's clear. Able. So what that means is that the referee's decision has to be overturned, and I have to award the championship back to Eric Lockhart. I'm sorry, brother.
Okay.
Back to regular scheduled programming.
Hey, Eric, how was that hospital trip you took? did you call the ambulance, or did somebody do that for you? Because it doesn't seem like you can get anything done by yourself. Especially when it comes to my television.
It's a Lockhart Television Championship. Doing things by myself, you had a whole referee help you win.
A whole referee? Did a whole referee kick you upside the head and lay you out?
I'll tell you what, have you ever heard of Any Given Sunday? That's you, Clay. Any Given Sunday. 99 out of 100, I can beat you. You got lucky.
Got lucky. I don't need luck to aim for that stupid haircut of yours and knock you out. In fact, I would do it every single time.
I wasn't even knocked out. My foot was under the rope. It's called ring awareness.
Every single
time. Prove it.
You hear that?
We have a championship match. Now that's good for business, and that's just butter, baby.
Introducing first, from Miller, Texas, Grizzle Robinson.
Our main event is upon us, as we have the final boss, the cornerstone of reality of wrestling, Ryan Davidson, meeting quite a tough task ahead of him, Brittany.
Yes, he's got a task in Lexis King, NXT's own, but, I mean, Ryan Davidson has been here before.
Sure.
He's traveled all over the world wrestling, and a high-profile match like this is just another walk in the park for him.
But I can tell you one thing is for sure, Lexis King is not going to be a walk in the park at all. There's a reason he is an NXT standout, and there's a reason he's meeting Ryan Davidson here tonight for the very first time.
And his opponent from Cincinnati, Ohio, he is the king of NXT, Lexis King.
The king of NXT is here at the Reality of Wrestling, Brittany.
Well, look at that. He's just taking a seat, taking it all in.
I mean, he did say he didn't even want to be here this evening. He didn't want to be in Texas. He didn't want to be in Reality Wrestling, but he was doing Booker T a favor and felt that he needed to be here, but he's not even wanting to participate in this match.
Why would you not want to participate against Ryan Davidson? That's a tough test right there.
What? And he just tried to take my chair.
He is used to coming out of a throne on NXT. It slides out of the entranceway.
Yeah, I get that. But you know what? He's not the king of Texas. He's not even the Tiger King.
As once again, ladies and gentlemen, this is our main event here tonight. And what a showcase this is going to be as Lexis King tries to add his name to the list of NXT superstars that have made their way to Reality of Wrestling and pick up a victory. But against Ryan Davidson, it's going to be quite the tough task.
Well,
Now, Brittany, coming off a championship loss right into a high-profile match, do you think that Ryan Davidson will look past Lexis King in search of a rematch with Danny Limelight?
Well, look, of course that's going to be on the mind of Ryan Davidson, but, you know, he's been around the ring long enough to know that, yes, you can plan for the future, but you focus on the opponent right in front of you, and I think he's full-on locked in on Lexis King.
Now for you, Brad, now if you're Lexis King, how does it feel to go into the enemy's house and try to take a victory in their home field?
We know what they say, it's not a series until the road team gets a victory, right? And that is the element of surprise. Look, it doesn't matter that Lexis King has never been in the Reality of Wrestling Walker, Texas Lloyd Arena, because he's been on the biggest arena in this sport. That's the WWE television.
You said he was doing a favor to Booker T?
Yes, he said that he was doing, I had overheard him talking about how he didn't want to be here, speaking with Danny, and that he was doing a favor for Booker T by being here.
Well, just listening to the Raw Nation, I don't think they want him here either, as he ran right into Ryan Davidson in the center of the ring. You're supposed to go down, says Lexis King after that shoulder tackle. That's how you go down right there.
Lexis King may have underestimated the first ever Grand Slam champion in reality wrestling history, Ryan Davidson.
Look, is he crying?
Oh, and now slapped him right in the face. And Ryan,
that's smart strategy.
Where is he going?
I like what Lexis is doing. I like this idea. He's trying to get Ryan Davidson all riled up. He's trying to frustrate him. He's trying to get under his skin.
Now he's trying to leave.
Where's he going?
He's in the middle of the Row Nation. Lexis King, the king of NXT. I think it's about to catch a flight back to Florida.
Bye, Lexis. You didn't want to be here. I mean, I find that incredibly disrespectful.
Well, I mean, we're still in our traditional rules match, so MJ Bell, senior referee here, is doing the counts. If Lexis gets count out.
Well, I don't think Ryan wants this to end that way.
I mean, as arrogant or as whatever you want to call Lexis King, I don't think he wants to lose a match either. I mean, a win is a win and a win, regardless of whether he wants to be here or not. That's his pride on the line.
Well, if you win, you make more money as a sports athlete. That is fact. And the fact that he's trying to not even engage in a fight with Ryan Davidson.
He's got a big old contract right now with NXT. But Ryan Davidson trying to bring him back in unceremoniously. Does so, and a big chop to the chest.
Look at that!
Ryan Davidson now unloading on Lexis King in the corner. And that is the cornerstone of reality of wrestling. Going on all cylinders.
Ryan Davidson is done. He's going to finish this completely.
Look, Lexis King reaching out to the people. He's reaching out.
Are you trying to reach out to him?
Oh, look at that. Beautiful. Right there.
An up kick. And now the corner. That is steel. That holds the ring together. And now Lexis King created an opening for himself.
Oh! And an elbow to the back of the head and now to the chest of Ryan Davidson. Lexis King firmly in the driver's seat, or should I say sitting in the throne right now during this match.
Right now he is taking it to Ryan Davidson.
But what is Lexis thinking? Oh my goodness!
Clothesline takes down Ryan, and now into the cover here, but a kick out of two.
But Davidson still holding on. And
oh man! Now these two are truly taking it to each other, and I'm gonna ask both of you guys this. Will this be a bigger win for NXT taking down Ryan Davidson, or is Rowe, or is it gonna be big for Rowe if the representative wins the match?
It's a large piece for Rowe, for sure. You're asking me to choose between the man and the bear. I'm going to choose the bear every single time. But
you show favoritism. I think this means more for Lexis King to come in your debut in a company, especially one run by Booker T, and defeat the first ever Grand Slam champion of that company's history. Automatic royalty.
Do you think Lexis King even cares? I mean, Brian Davidson actually respects this ring, unlike Lexis King is showing.
Look, it's not about respect. It's about checks and championships. That's what he's here for. He's here to get paid, and he's here to prove why he lives up to that name of King.
Especially after taking the fight right here to Ryan Davidson, he's proving that he is definitely championship caliber. But getting that win could potentially propel him to something bigger, as right now going into the cover too. Oh, almost got him, did Lexis King there.
Look at that. Just going to work on that shoulder. That's the same shoulder that met with that exposed steel post.
And look at that. There's some massive arms to wrap around the neck and head of Ryan Davidson.
Yeah, Lex King in great shape. You've seen him month over month in NXT progressively get into better shape. And he's gained more confidence. And I gotta say, he's got a great beard. I just thought that would be a good moment to throw this out. Ryan Davidson down two. If his arm drops one more time.
Able to stay in it is Ryan Davidson.
Rock on, Ryan Davidson.
H-Town crowd. As right now, Ryan Davidson back up to his feet. Here we go. Lexis King jumping up on him to get a better base, but no. Gets put right into the corner. Big back body drop.
I don't think he'll be sitting on the throne much right now.
Ronation. Lending their energy to Ryan Davidson. Blocking that punch, throwing one of his own. And look at these right hands. Ryan Davidson sending Lexis King into the corner. Oh, big kick.
This could be it. Looking for a Davidson driver. Oh, not a full one there. But a bear trap fist drop.
Now into the cover. Ryan Davidson with a huge victory.
No.
Ryan Davidson almost picked up a victory over Lexis King here.
If Ryan Davidson wins, I know championships are not on the line here. There's no championship belt to be had, but does that make Ryan Davidson the king of NXT?
I think King might be a little...
Look at that big super kick right there.
A little too much. We call him the cornerstone for a reason, because he's earned it. As now... Big power slam! Cover! Shoulders are down! Two! But a kick out from King!
That is one of the most beautiful power slams I have seen in a while.
And look at this here now. Ryan Davidson unloading with those right hands, or right forearms, I should say. Lexis King is being taken to his limit right now, Brittany.
Right there. Getting up to a vertical base. Ryan Davidson's got him in that fireman's carry position.
Oh,
look at that.
Oh,
look at that. Referee didn't see it. Great move right there by Lex King. I got to call it like it is. Any advantage you can
around.
Get.
He's got him set up. Is he about to just crowd him?
No.
The coronation gets countered. Coronation got countered, now Ryan Davidson. Possibly going on for the Davidson driver. Roll through, shoulders are down. One, two. He shot him right into the referee, inadvertently.
MJ Bell, Lexis King, not meaning to do that.
MJ Bell is getting hit right in the face.
Official is down, Ryan Davidson taking up Lexis King. Davidson driver.
No referee here, going for the cover.
One, two, three. Ryan Davidson has this match won, but there's no official.
Ryan just realizing there is no official to count the
fall. He's still trying to hold on to that leg, trying to hope that our referee will resuscitate.
Lexis King was out for the count right there, but there was no referee to make the count.
As far as I'm concerned, Ryan Davidson is...
Wait a second.
That's the Empire State Champion.
Danny Limelight. Danny Limelight, we saw him. Friendship of him and Lexis King.
Oh, look at that.
What? The Empire State Championship to the cranium.
No.
Of the four. Lexis champion.
The way he just hit Ryan Davidson, I'm pretty sure you're gonna see Ryan's face imprinted on the gold. It's now Lexis King going into the cover here. One, two, and oh my God.
He did it. The king of NXT, victorious in his Raw debut.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Lexis King.
Lexis King picking up the victory here in tonight's main event, but not without some help from the Empire State Champion, Danny Limelight.
Well, Lexis King did what he needed to do, secure a victory. Danny Limelight made his presence felt, but guess what? Referee never saw him.
Disgusting debut of Lexis King here. Getting the victory, but...
How was getting a victory disgusting? He took advantage of a situation.
The referee
was down. He didn't hit anybody with a belt. That was Danny Limelight. Be mad at Danny Limelight. Don't be mad at a king. Don't be mad at a king for an incredible victory.
The fact of the matter is the record books are going to say that Lexis King defeated Ryan Davidson. But again, the footage will show that it wasn't without some help from Danny Limelight.